Today on Mike Attempts, Mazda brake fluid flush. Mazda recommends flushing the brake fluid every 2 years, so let's get to it. I could not find the bleed sequence for our Mazda 6, so I'm going to use the default. Typically, you'd start with the caliper furthest from the master cylinder, which would be the passenger side rear, but check your manual to be sure. Set the parking brake, jack up the car, and remove the wheel. Remove this rubber dust cap to access the bleeder screw. I like to give them a little squirt of penetrating oil because it makes me feel good. While that's soaking in, pop the hood and remove the master cylinder cap. Our Mazda uses DOT 3, but check your cap to be sure. There's a filter screen inside that can be a bit of a pain to remove because of these little tabs meant to hold it in place. This inexpensive one-person bleeder bottle makes this job much faster and easier. It has a strong magnet so you can stick it to the caliper or rotor. The key is this one-way check valve that helps prevent air from entering the system, which eliminates the need for a second person. Suck the old fluid from the reservoir with a turkey baster. You know better than to use the one from the kitchen, just go buy one for the garage. Brake fluid eats paint, so try not to spill any. Refill the reservoir with your favorite brand. Attach the hose to the bleeder and crack it open with a 10mm wrench. You only want to open it about a quarter of a turn. Press the brake pedal and if it won't go down, open the bleeder a bit more. Now we can see fluid in the tube. The goal is to be able to press the pedal down, but also have it come back up on its own. If it goes down easily and won't come back up, close the bleeder just a hair. Pump the brake 5 or 6 times and top off the fluid. You must keep the reservoir full, or air will be sucked into the brake lines and you'll need to do much more bleeding to remove all the bubbles. Repeat the pumping and top offs until you can see clean fluid in the tube. I aim for around half a bottle per caliper. If you've replaced a component in the brake system, then you'll need more than 2 bottles to bleed out all of the air. Tighten the bleeder, remove the tube, wipe up any drips, and replace the rubber cap. Move to the next wheel and repeat the process. Keep an eye on the fluid level. Don't go nuts when tightening the bleeder. You'll make this job much longer if you break one off. On a side note, I normally use an air impact wrench, but I picked up this cordless mid-torque impact and I'm loving it. The dust cap is larger on the front bleeders. The calipers are larger too, so there's plenty of room for the bottle. Without a bottle like this one, you'd have to have someone else push down the brake pedal while you open the bleeder. Then you'd need to tighten the bleeder before they let the pedal back up. You and your buddy would need to repeat this process many times for each caliper. Last one. Be thorough when cleaning up. You don't want to see a drip on the floor and think there's a problem when there really isn't. Clean and replace the filter screen, fill to the max line, reinstall the cap, and wipe off the reservoir. Take it for a test drive, check for leaks, and you're done. Feel free to rate this video, add your comments and questions below, and subscribe for more.